think you recognize the gentleman with me, Chief of Staff, Senator Baker. Well, please, be seated. What is going on behind closed doors? I must believe that what you reported from this summit was some of the best news, the growth of the number of weapons. Both sides are now focused on ways to mutually reduce the Western democracies to have trust in a government that doesn't trust its own people and denies their human rights. So be assured that responsibility demonstrated by the alliance during the sensitive negotiations we've gone through in the summit and in the weeks and months before the summit. And now with that said,
General Secretary Gorbachev this week go around the Capitol, meet with people on the streets, with reporters, with business groups. We saw one perspective. From your aides and advisors, we hear another perspective, as a tight bargainer as opposed to the polished salesman of himself and his country. Could you tell us, please, from your impression, which is the real Mikhail Gorbachev?
I think they're both real.
If I can follow up, the relationship between the two of you also seemed to change. From Reykjavik, where it seemed a little bit strained, to this time where it seemed a little more natural. Was that just a general progression of relationships as people know better, or was there a difference in bargaining?
I think you're taking Reykjavik down to one final hour.
Yeah, a follow-up? For example, an anecdote of that relationship.
I'm Fred Fisk from the Post Standard up in Syracuse, New York. In the past, the START talks seem to have been held hostage, if you will, by the SDI, Star Wars, and ABM compliance dispute. Do you feel as a result of your summit meeting with Mr. Gorbachev that those obstacles have been reduced or indeed eliminated?
We have made great progress.
President,
I'll get to you next.
Mr. President, Bill Butel from WABC TV in New York. Back in the we met on Connecticut Avenue on the way to the White House yesterday.
Well, by the time we got here and we
had... Trudy Rubin from the Philadelphia Inquirer. To follow up on the SDI question, Mr. President, have the Soviets agreed to drop their objections to the U.S. testing under the broad interpretation of the ABM treaty? And was the agreement that you reached a breakthrough? Does the formula resolve the issue, or does it merely postpone it for now?
No, it resolves it.
Hustle Times, John Anderson from Hustle Times. Can you categorically state now that Star Wars or SDI is no longer any impediment in the START talks that is completely put aside?
I don't think there's any impediment there at all. Well,
some limited movement was made on the human rights issues. Can you talk a little bit more about what slight progress may have been made in those areas?
Well, individuals who have been prevented from getting visas or who are incarcerated. And this is because what we've been following here is a policy of getting names and creating lists. And we have presented those lists touring the countryside and see America and get acquainted with it. They don't think they're violating any human rights. They think we are. Let me take this young lady here and then back there.
First of all, thank you very much for a very exciting week and at this level, KBW Buffalo. Western New York is the home of the Chicago Institution, where for the last 3 years we have had private peace initiatives and exchanges with the Soviets. We are going back again next May. How do you view these private peace initiatives following your summit?
Oh, not only do we view them well.
Spoken about the improved relationship between the two of you as being one of the benefits of this summit. If that's the case, why not expand upon it and do, as you just suggested, meet more often, even during the treaty side? Or do like you did this morning, pick up the phone and call him more often?
Well, we stay in communicado going forward with the things that were discussed here and which in 3 days you can't completely agree on all the things that must be resolved. But we will be going forward in contact.
We've heard a lot about nuclear weapons. Can you tell us a little bit about what has been done this week with chemical weapons and where you see that headed?
I think one of the most hopeful signs is that he, not me, reduction in military in arms all the way across the board.
What specifically did you discuss on chemical weapons and where do you go from there?
Well, no, just that, as I say, he brought that up as a part of the subject that we've got to go forward with as a right, specifically we're going on, as I say, the nuclear weapons, because these are the things we've been discussing, but he made it plain but he doesn't want to stop there. He wants arms reduction, period.
President, Joe Gate, WNEP in Boston. The American people know you very well, but they don't know Mr. Gorbachev very well. You know him better than anybody else. Do you believe he's a good man, and do you completely trust him?
I think I've been involved in the communist situation long before I was in this office. I was once president of the union in the motion picture industry. I no proviae. Trust, but verify.
Mr. President, can I follow on that, Mr. President, for John Fox, fellow of New York. You have described in the past that the Soviet Union is an evil empire, and you said that communism would be swept in the dustpan of history. Do you still feel that way?
Well, I think the very has been the enormous economic problem.
Yeah.
Process provided in the INF Treaty leaves more than 90% of the Soviet Union off limits to U.S. inspectors. And doesn't that leave a lot of room for cheating? And I'm concerned about that possibility.
You always have to be concerned about that. And just as I'm sure they are too. To stop a weapon coming out of the plant, have the hood removed and count the number of warheads that it contains to see that it is meeting the requirements. Both of we've agreed.
You place great emphasis upon these rigorous and intrusive verification procedures, yet short of withdrawal from the treaty, there's no specific provision for compensatory or penalties should the Soviets be found cheating. Now, you abrogated SALT II on the basis of Soviet cheating. Would you favor and support doing the same thing with the INF if they're found to be cheating, or should the Senate attach specific penalties should the Soviets be found to be cheating on INF?
No, I think that we want to withdraw, and he would do that within a 12-month period at the most. And he has some concerns then about our continued support and demanding that the Congress should disarm themselves. And I, in turn, have made it plain to them that there's no way that we come together and the people of that country decide on the kind of government they want and a neutral government.
Just as a follow-up, do you think it would be best for
be resolved, and we believe is probably a really historic event and the most forward thing that has happened between our two countries in the last 40 years. And
WROK in Rockford, Illinois. You characterized the successful signing of the INF as one of the most important actions concerning nuclear weapons since World War II. If I could ask you to speak personally, how do you characterize this successful agreement as far as your accomplishments in office since 1980? Important part of the Reagan, is this the most important aspect of the Reagan legacy? 100 years from now, will we look back and see Ronald Reagan improve relations with the Soviets?
I don't expect to be looking back.
President, one last question.
Oh, I'm sorry.
We too in South Florida are a little concerned about the communist influence in our back door. Recently, we have normalized relations with, relaxed immigration policies with Cuba. What would you have to say to folks in South Florida about all of
that? Well, having been a governor of the state myself and believing in federalism, I have to say that
with the number of people we expect to be coming into South Florida, there are real and severe economic concerns about how we can cope with.
Immigration plan, but again, I have to say that.
In the verification terms, will the security of our vital defense systems become vulnerable? And also, at the next proposed summit in Moscow, what's the status of the bug American embassy?
They know very well how we feel about that.
Could you explain that order and exactly what those troops would have been authorized to do?
Very quietly, I issued an order that troops could be made available. Only that was the total extent of the order.
In what way would they?
Thank you very much.
I have to get along with her from here on
out.
Starting with my dispatcher.
That's right. Don't want to keep her waiting.
One this round.
I think the people of both countries want.
How are we going to come to the
Thank you.